I'm going to pause for a moment. It's not really a pause, but I want to... we're kind of on this train of the fundamentals of computation. We're just plowing through all these concepts. But I want to stop for a moment and just talk about a function in processing that, that you might not see in a lot of examples, but it, you will inevitably want to use all the time. println, or print line, and it gets some arguments here. Here's the thing, you know, your stuff is going to go wrong all the time. You're going to write some code, you're going to run it, it's going to have an error in it, you're going to fix the error, then you're going to run it, but it's not going to do what you expected it to do, and you're going to feel sad and stressed out, and you know, you'll get some tea, and you'll relax, and you'll ask a friend, and things will eventually be okay. But there is a process there about figuring out, and this is really what I want to say, is that it's very different, the scenario where your code doesn't run and you get an error because you have a typo, and your code runs, there are no errors, but it doesn't do what you imagine it to do. And there's lots and lots of debugging, or debugging techniques to sort of get the bugs out of your program. There's a lot of strategies for doing that that hopefully we'll see as I make these videos. And you know, if there's any good thing about me not rehearsing or planning any of these videos, hopefully I'll make mistakes as I'm kind of doing examples, and we'll see some debugging during the course of these videos. But we haven't gotten very far yet, so we're not really ready for all the tools we might have. But this is a tool for sort of figuring out when something goes wrong that you might want to have at your disposal right now. So let's look at what this does. The first thing that I should just say is that if you have, so you can put anything in here. I could write in quotes the word hello, and this will print hello to processing's message console. Where is the message console, right? There's like the toolbar up here. You have some code you've written. There's a little, there's a place down here where those errors appear, right? Where messages spit out if something goes wrong with your program. You can print stuff to down there yourself. It's not part of the application window, but it's extra information as the program's running. So you could put a string of characters in there. You could put a number in there. But you could also do something like this, println circle x. And you will see the value of circle x printed out down there. Why would this be useful? So let's go over here and look at the program. This is what we've been working on. It's a program that draws a circle on the screen with an initial location, and maybe that circle's x location changes. And if we run it, we can look at it and see like, oh, there's no circle. What's going on? I have a variable called circle x. I'm drawing the ellipse at circle x, and I have this line of code, but I don't see the circle. So obviously this is a canned scenario that I created, and perhaps you can even just look at this and already see what the problem is, but let's pretend that you can't. So one strategy we have is to say print ln circle x, and when I run this program, now we can see down here, look, the message console, all of these values are printing out. This is the current value of circle x. Now we look at this and we know instantly, okay, I know why I'm not seeing it on the screen. The value of circle x is some really high negative number. There's no negative pixels on the screen. Processing's like pretending to draw it way off. So that's why we don't see it. That's what's broken. Okay, so how, now that gives us a clue at least to figuring out what the problem is. Now, I could guess like, well, maybe I should comment out this line of code and run it again. What's the value of circle x? Oh, it's zero all the time. That makes sense. That was its initial value. And so this line of code must somehow be making it negative. Oh, of course. I'm adding a random number between negative 2 and 0, so I'm never incrementing it by a positive number. Circle x starts at 0 and only ever gets to be negative. What I meant to do was say not between negative 2 and 0, but between 0 and 2. And now I run my program. Oh, it's on the screen. It's moving. And I see that the value of circle x is now positive. So this is just, this is just a really quick video just to show you that this is a tool that's available to you. You might kind of practice with it. You can do interesting things, like you can actually put a string of characters in here with a plus sign. So if I write the code like this, this isn't adding, but in the case of print line, we're going to see more about this when we learn about strings later. We want to print line circle x colon and then the value of circle x. So if I run it, we can see that's what's being printed out now down there, circle x colon. And this is useful if you want to print multiple values out and you need to label them, and you can go all sorts of crazy with this, and I'm going to turn off, stop recording, and then just make lots of pretty, like, elaborate print line statements on my own, because I enjoy doing that. But I don't think you need to worry too much about this. Most of the stuff you're doing right now, you're going to be able to fix and solve through trial and error, kind of creating these simple programs. But this is just a quick little video to show you about print line. And hopefully that was useful.